Yung nakikinig naman. Yung ba, makikita yung score. And just choose who to pass to. Walang pressure on the passer. Absolutely none. I mean, I'm fine with Eddie to shoot the three, but not that much. Where you're leaving him as a point guard of sorts to just target the point passes inside. Look at that. Too easy.
Yeah. I see what you're saying. He's got clear vision.
Oh, also from the angle. Now, Gorbatov is testing at the free throw line. Earlier, we saw Sheriff miss two free throws. Now, the Bear. And for Torres, this is his first trip to the line.
Three throws, maybe come. Factor here.
How's he going? Oh, jump. Not jump, but he didn't keep another trick to the Bear. So.
Okay, we'll go to UST.
Uh-huh. This game has been played. In East Princeton. Yes, and I would say,
if you look at this new more play on the game brought to you by Arizona, I won't let you down.
Played well from a quality standpoint. There are no overly chippy moves here. The physicality is just what you expect. It's going to get tougher as Mariano sticks his way through as the series goes on. But for game number one, we expected a real physical battle. Well, it's not that physical in a hurricane sense. But believe it or not, within 32 minutes, that was Mariano's first 2 points of the game. First 2 points for Alto. Jared is holding on to his ankle. He stands up and shrugs it off. Uh-oh.
Oh, can they not go? That was nice. 3-2.
Torres.
It's a foul, and of course, from Sheriff, and I think that is his fourth.
Could have flipped that over his shoulder to Jaron Ten, but Thomas felt he had the advantage on the run. Look at his quick drive to the basket. He's been so quiet all game long.
He's been so quiet pretty much the whole season. DJ, Rubens, Crispin, juicy wingers, no bumps on the play.
I mean, when I say that compared to last year, when he was coming off the bench, remember? He was a sixth man, and he was Mr. Clutch for them. And he still has the bone spurs on his ankle. It still hurts him. He says he's not 100%. He's never been 100% this whole season.
This year, yes.
Remember, he re-injured that mid-season. Just as he was getting there,
Thomas Saunders knocks down the free throw, 7 points for him. And it's a one possession lead. Mata to USD. Burke hits back. Saunders moves out. Norbert, that is. Now, this is where it gets interesting for both teams. In the 9-game winning streak of LaSalle, they have demonstrated such poise and composure down the stretch. Obviously, so has UST,
right?
With their experience. So this will get very interesting. Who will blink first?
Who will meet the two?
Oh, that's a goaltending.
Would have been, but I'm going to use it. What now? The refs said
it hit the board.
Wait, now
we have to look at that again. We have to look at that again. And from our angle, it looked like it.
It's the release.
Wow, right before.
What close.
Right before.
That's close.
Nevertheless, Abdul with two free throws.
Superb. Kareem Abdul today, 4 out of 5 from the free throw line.
This is a luxury at this point. To do possession lead.
Magdadasala ang mga taga Espanya.
Prayer answer there. 5-point lead. 2-12 remaining.
That's a big lead. The way this game has been going.
Yes. Luxury. Let's see how LaSalle responds. Perkins for three. Get on to go. Straight off the pitch. And on the last 2 minute mark, seemed it up with the points of PS back over the series account now. It is Abby Valadina. A luxury 5-point lead. So, what she was also. Great response by both teams here. And Brooklyn's just came off the bench.
Yes.
Dang, turns around.
is out as Sal was in that play with a, you know, you appreciate that camera angle. Kung gano'ng kalag yung Nasal at bakit kurang pag-rotate yung defensa ng USC. Mariano was dipping down, waiting for someone to drive, and he saw that his man, he was assigned to work, it was just wide open.
KBO, knocking it in.
2 for 2 so far today. Arnold Vanopso, his other trip to the line earlier, was on a 3-point play. They need this one to keep